The acceptable stability range for cross-arch immediate loading with a provisional implant prosthesis is a measurement somewhere between. This multi-level surgical guide is designed to sit directly on the bone. Therefore, a full thickness flap was reflected, extending the flap to ensure the guide fully seats just on the bone and no tissue interferes. Next, the foundation guide and the mounting guide were connected with the blue interlocking pins prior to being positioned intraorally. The foundation guide seats only on the buckle surface. To ensure the guide is seated in the correct position, we have to utilize this mounting guide to verify the fit by ensuring it is flush with the bone. Once in a stable position, the anchor pin osteotomies were drilled, and yellow anchor pins were placed to secure this foundation guide in place. We then remove the blue interlocking pins, and the mounting guide is removed, leaving the foundation guide by itself securely in place. The platform of the foundation guide is then utilized for bone reduction guide. A flat instrument can be used to verify the bone reduction and make sure it is even with the flat surface of this foundation guide. The osteotomy guide is then seated on top of the foundation guide, and the same blue interlocking pins are reinserted to secure this portion of the guide in place. With the guide secured, the osteotomies were sequentially drilled following the approved digital treatment plan. The drilling sequence was performed according to the pre-planned guided surgical protocol. HahnTM tapered implants were placed with ease, being sure to align the hex of the implant mount with the hex of the surgical guide sleeve. After the implants were placed, the interlocking pins and the osteotomy guide were then removed. The implant stability quotient, or ISQ value, was calculated using the Penguin 2 osseointegration monitor. The acceptable stability range for cross-arch immediate loading with a provisional implant prosthesis is a measurement somewhere between 55 and 85. Ideally, I prefer to achieve at least a value in the mid to upper 60s when immediate loading cross-arch implant restorations. For single unit restorations, I do not load a restoration lower than a value of 70.